Absolutely. And you know, a space that has sort of tested investors' patience is the capital goods space. But today we have a company on our radar. Kotak Institutional Equities has in fact upgraded Thermax to a buy as they believe the positives are sufficient to counter the weak coal market. MS Unnikrishnan, the managing director at Thermax, joins us now to give us a quick mood check on what's happening in the CAPEX space as well as if there's any pickup as far as orders are concerned. Mr. Unnikrishnan, good morning and thanks so much for joining in. You know, I wanted to first start, before I ask you about orders, etc., first I want to start by asking you what's happening with collection of payments, because since we spoke with you the last time, a lot of companies have indicated to us that there is a big delay as far as government receivables are concerned. Has there been any improvement there and how is the situation on the ground now?
Well, there is no noticeable improvement in collections from the public sector undertakings or the government departments. Thermax doesn't do much of work with the government, only PSUs we do work with. Even in that one, outstandings have gone up only, it has not come down. Okay. Despite we taking it up with the finance minister and also informing that the root cause for most of this is at the time when you do the tendering itself, you keep as a retention of 10% and 20% and 30%. And that will pile up and which will impact the entire downstream payment. So it has not improved in any way at this point of time. However, in the entire private industry, there is nothing negative to report in the last 1 or 2 months between the time when we spoke to each other related to payments. Projects are moving. I don't have to see any projects getting cancelled nor anything getting delayed. So overall, if you look at it, barring the PSU, which continues to be the same way, they continue to be misbehaving, all others are in order only.
Okay. Good morning, Mr. Unnikrishnan. What's your split in terms of sources of orders, government and non-government?
We normally restricted to around 30% of the total carry forward at the current juncture, because there aren't as many private orders. Otherwise, in the best of the time, we will normally restrict it to
20%. 20% is government or 20% is government, you mean?
Only 20% government in good days, and in very bad days like this, we keep up to 30%.
Okay.
So 70% to 80% of all our orders are from private industry.
Okay. And how is that
either
piece?
In India or outside India?
How is that piece?
It is moving quite okay.
No, is there order flow?
In fact, there is. Let our order conclusions are getting delayed, and though there are no order losses, but substantial quantum of private industry medium-sized orders are on the verge of conclusion, but nobody is signing on the dotted line, nor are they signing a check and giving it. So there is some kind of a sentimental laxity in the market prevailing, for whatever is the reason.
So
in my opinion, everything is conducive right now, because we are almost at the bottom. And time has come for many to be starting to act and place orders, but it isn't happening.
So Mr. Unnikrishnan, since you mentioned that the outstandings for Thermax has gone up, especially from PSUs, would this worsen your working capital situation, and what is the receivable situation at the moment?
Well, thankfully, we have been able to bring it down in the last quarter. See, we are an exception in comparison to many of the industry practices. My DSO has come down from 109 days to almost 90 days at the end of the last quarter. It is almost remaining closer to that only, despite whatever could have happened in the market. However, in the industry, when you asked the question, was not for Thermax alone, capital goods industry is to collect a lot more money from the PSUs and the government departments, which is true.
Okay, Mr. Unnikrishnan, can you tell us which industries are giving orders?
Well, last, say, 3 to 4 months, the orders that got concluded of substantial size are from the cement industry for waste heat recovery based power plants. And there were three fresh capacities, two of them brownfield expansion, one a greenfield project got concluded. We have picked up two orders, and my competitors have picked up another one. Currently, we have the oil and gas industry again opening up. Balmer refinery tendering is out, and some ordering has already happened. Our turn is going to be happening in Q4 to Q1 for the energy equipments and Balmer refinery. We have two more refineries in the offing, Panipat as well as Gujarat refinery. My expectation is the beginning of the next year, some of those orders will also happen. So in the largest sector, these are the only two where I am seeing some movement happening. However, nothing happening in the steel industry, nothing in the power industry, nothing in the fertilizer industry.
So, what quantum of your orders currently are already at a tendered stage? I mean, if you can just help us with that, what percentage as well?
See, we have 5,400 crore worth of carry forward orders, and all of them are moving. There is nothing on tender stage in that one.
Okay.
There are a couple of orders where we are L1, where we are yet to be getting the order signed and contract signed for that, which should take maybe a few months or so, because there are delays in order conclusion, as I mentioned about. Otherwise, we don't participate in too many tenders. Oil industry, which I mentioned about, Thermax is participating, which could happen possibly in Q4 or Q1 of next year. Otherwise, ours is predominantly the private industry and also international orders from various parts of the world.
Okay. Mr. Unnikrishnan, a final question to you. You said that a lot of orders are just at the penultimate stage and should be signed. What is your sense? Are we troughing out and you will be telling us about a lot more signed orders in a month or two?
Lata, not too many. There are a couple of them.
Okay.
Otherwise, the market should get a very positive indication.
Okay.
There are orders which are concluded, but contract yet to be signed in both in India and outside India. I am expecting them to be happening in the next 2 to 3 months, or maybe at the best February, March. We will be declaring each one of them.
Okay.
But that's again, let me clarify to you that it is not a phenomena happening in the market overall.
Okay.
The sectors which I mentioned are concluding orders.
Okay.
So there, either me or my competitors would certainly be reporting order intake in the coming months.
Do you think the global economy will be able to pull us out a little bit out of this trough? Are your international orders doing a little better than domestic orders?
Unfortunately, no. I mean, when India has got a fever, looks like the entire world is having a fever.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, talking about North America, but the rest of the world, Southeast Asia, Middle East, Africa and South America seem to be following exactly the same trend that is prevailing in India.
Mm-hmm.
Inquiries being there, discussions happening, contracts not getting signed, Lata. That's the reality on the ground.
Okay, all right, Mr. Unnikrishnan. We always trust you to tell us exactly how the situation is on the ground. You've never minced words, and thank you for that. We hope to speak with you once again very soon. That's Thermax saying that they are perhaps close to the bottom of the CAPEX cycle, but still when it comes to PSUs or the government, there's still delays as far as payment is concerned. Let's take a look at the financials posted by Thermax in the past few years. First, we have the revenue picture of the company. It's been all over the place, actually a bit volatile, you'd have to say. Next is the operating profit margin performance. That as well has seen a dip from FY18 to FY19. And also take a look at the company's recent net profits in the past. That's been good actually. Good jump up there. Finally, Thermax EPS on your screen. Actually, it's been a volatile last couple of years for them.
Yeah, but then capital goods have been like that.
Yes.
You shouldn't be surprised at all. It was a judicious mix of optimism and a large dose of caution from Mr. Unnikrishnan. Well, we have to take a break, but just a word on the markets. It was slightly in the green when it started. It is slightly in the red after the first 15-20 minutes of trading.